Systems and apparatus for concentrating sunlight are often used in the field of photovoltaics. So, for example, shown here is this parabolic disc, and it collects the sunlight coming from the sun, and then it concentrates into this narrow beam, which is made incident on the solar cells. And many times these concentrated photovoltaic systems, they use these multi-junction solar cells, which have this multiple junctions, which have higher efficiency for solar conversion. Shown here is another such system. So over here you have this Fresnel lens, which is placed over here. And this is collecting again all the sunlight coming from the sun. It concentrates it into this narrow beam, which is then made incident on this solar cell. So these systems currently, they have concentrations of 500x or 1000x or 1500x. What I'm interested in finding out in this video is what is the fundamental limit, or you know, how much x of concentration you can achieve for these systems. So in this video, I want to investigate, is there a fundamental limit or is there a thermodynamic limit for this light concentration? So let's get started. So the first thing I'll do is essentially I'll consider that I have this receptor over here, and this has a surface area of S. So how much power of sunlight can be made incident on this receptor? And I'll relate it to the brightness of my source, which is sun. So I'll relate it to the brightness of the source, which I'll denote by B with a subscript S, standing for source or sun, whichever way you want to take it. And I want to relate it to this angle which the sun subtends on Earth. So many times we consider the light which is incident from the sun just as a source of these parallel rays. But in fact, the sun has a finite radius, and it has there's a finite distance from which the sun and the Earth are separated. So this angle is a very small angle, but nonetheless, it's a finite angle, and it's equal to approximately 0.27 degrees. So this is the angle which sun subtends at a point source located on the Earth. So this brightness from the sun is incident on this point source, which has a surface area ds within this solid angle. So I can relate this power to essentially the brightness of the source, and it's related by this angle, by this factor of sine squared theta. And there's a factor of pi, which comes from this geometric averaging. So you integrate this over this small solid angle, and you get this factor of pi. If you want to understand more where this formula comes from, you can read this Wikipedia article. And many a times this principle of you know, expressing light in this way is called a principle of Ethandieu conservation, or conservation of Ethandieu. And so we can express the power incident as essentially this pi times the area of this disk, which is S, and then sine square of this angle, sine square alpha, into the brightness of my source. And you might recall that sine alpha or sine square alpha, I can also express this as a numerical aperture. So I can also express this power as essentially square of my numerical aperture times my area times the brightness of the source. So this is another way to remember this formula. So now let's see how can I concentrate it, and then what is the power incident on my disk on which I'll place my solar cells. So what I've done over here is shown that initially I had this surface which was collecting the sunlight facing the sun, and this had an area of S. And now I've placed this concentrated optics over here. So this will essentially take this light incident on the surface S and concentrate it to this disk which has an area of let's say sigma over here. So just like I did for this bigger disk, I can express the total power incident on the smaller disk, which has an area sigma, as essentially pi times the area of the disk, sigma, multiplied by this angle, sine square of this angle, which my receptor is now subtending on the smaller disk. So it's, let's say, subtending this angle of 2 beta, then essentially I'll have a factor of sine square beta, multiplied by the brightness of the receptor. So this is the power which is now concentrated on this smaller disk. And now what I'm interested in finding is this concentration, or how many times I've concentrated my light. And I can express that as essentially the area of this bigger disk divided by this area of the smaller disk. And that gives me the concentration, or how many times I've reduced the area, that many times I've increased my concentration. Now, important thing to note is that the power which was incident on this bigger disk is now concentrated into this power into the smaller disk. But I'll have the conservation of power, assuming that there's no power which is lost during this concentrating process. The power which was incident on this bigger disk has to be equal to the power incident on the smaller disk. So I can equate this power incident on the smaller disk. I can equate it to the power which was incident on the bigger disk, which is pi times the area of the bigger disk, multiplied by sine square times this alpha, into the brightness of my source, which was sun. So now I can equate these two things, and I see that if I equate, I can essentially get a ratio of this S pi sigma. So I can express this S times sine square alpha multiplied by the brightness of the source. This must be equal to sigma times this equation, which is sigma times sine square beta multiplied by the brightness of the receptor. So I get this relationship for my concentration. Now what I'm interested in finding out is the maximum value of this concentration. So let's see when this concentration would be maximum. So I have this BR by BS term over here, and this concentration would be maximum when this ratio is maximum. So BR is the brightness of my receptor, and BS is the brightness of my source, which is the sun. So what is the maximum value of this ratio? So the maximum value of this ratio could only be 1, because my receptor, it cannot be more brighter as compared to the sun, because that would violate my second law of thermodynamics. That would say essentially that my receptor has become more hotter, or it's emitting out more brightness as compared to the sun, which is not possible. So the maximum value of this ratio has to be essentially equal to 1. Similarly, what is the other thing I can maximize over here? So this sine square alpha is pretty much fixed by the geometry of the sun and how far the sun is from the earth. But this sine square beta, so this is something I can optimize. But the maximum value of this sine square beta can essentially be only equal to the 1. And that would be the case when this all this light, or this beta, is equal to 90 degrees. And in that case, the maximum value of the concentration I'll get is essentially this term will be equal to 1, this term will be equal to 1, and the maximum value of the concentration would be essentially 1 divided by sine square of alpha. Now I've done this analysis so far, assuming that my concentrator system, it had a refractive index of 1, but I could as well as make this concentrated system in a material which has a refractive index of n. And in that case, what will happen is that my numerical aperture, it will essentially increase from sine theta to essentially n sine theta, or my numerical aperture will increase n time. As a result of that, this power intensity, which is incident, with this power which is incident on the smaller disk, will essentially increase by a factor of n squared. You know, I can now essentially get I can concentrate light from a larger acceptance angle, which is increased by a factor of n. So what I'll see in this power, I'll essentially see a factor of n squared sine square beta instead of just sine square beta. as a result of that, in this concentration as well, I'll see a factor of n squared, and this maximum concentration will instead become scaled by a factor of n squared as well. So I'll get the value of maximum concentration to be this if I make my this receptor and this concentrated system in a medium which has a refractive index of n. So now I see that the maximum value of my concentration, it's essentially given by n squared divided by this sine squared alpha. And I know that alpha is essentially fixed to be equal to approximately 0.27 degrees. So if I substitute that and into this formula, I get a value of this maximum concentration to be approximately equal to n squared times 45,032. So if I make this concentrated system in a medium of refractive index of 1, then I can get a maximum concentration of approximately 45,000. And as I mentioned earlier, most of the concentrated systems today, they operate at a concentration of maximum concentration of 1000x or 1500x, which is limited by if you go higher than this concentration, you tend to heat up your cell and your efficiency starts to degrade. But you see that from a fundamental perspective, there's a lot of headroom in terms of how much we can increase this concentration. So there's a lot of headroom till we hit the fundamental limit.